Welcome to Memorial Arena in beautiful Brampton, Ontario, for today's edition of CWHL Live. We've got the Calgary Inferno here in Brampton to take on the hometown Brampton Thunder. The Thunder come in after winning last night's game in overtime, 4-3. It's a 12-5 record on the season. We'll take a quick break here for the national anthem. Just about ready to go here, just moments away from puck drop. We're going to take a look now at tonight's starting goalies. In goal for the Calgary Inferno, it's Delaney Bryan coming in, having played 11 games with a record of 8-1-1, suffering the overtime loss at the hand of the same Thunder last night. She said with the goals against the average of 2.63. And on the other end of the ice for the hometown Brampton Thunder, getting her second consecutive start here against Calgary, it's Erica Howe. She picked up the win yesterday. She sits with a record of 7-3, having participated in now in 11 games. The goals against average of 1.81, having a fantastic year, is Erica Howe. Early in the year, Coach Tyler Fine is choosing to rotate his goalies more often than not, but Howe has gotten the lion's share of work of late with Thunder. As mentioned before, Brampton coming into this game with a record of 12-5 for the season. Calgary, on the other hand, at 12-2-1. A win here for the Thunder would give them sole possession of first place in the CWHL, though Calgary does have two games in hand. Here we are with Puck Drop, and while you're watching the game today, don't forget to join us on social media. I'm at Darren Alley. You can follow the CWHL at the CWHL as we get an early icing call here against Calgary. The two teams today are at Brampton CWHL and at Calgary CWHL. So quick icing and an offensive zone draw just 10 seconds here into the game for Brampton. Vint, fresh off scoring her 10th of the season last night. She loses the draw. Calgary controls behind their own goal. Taken by Seedhouse. To the point, LaRocque can't handle it, and it skips out of the zone. Edney finds McParland. She dumps it in past Padula and doesn't stay there long. Jump down now. Saulnier all alone on goal. Scores! Jill Saulnier with her second goal of the weekend. And early, just 28 seconds into the game, it's 1-0 Calgary. We're going to take another look at that one. McParland tries to dump it in the Calgary zone. Quickly cleared out. And Saulnier, all alone on the other side of the Brampton blue line, pots it past Howe and gives her team a one-goal lead early. Calgary on the move again. Now Davis looking for the puck. And that's intercepted by Bertrand. Davis on her again, and it'll be taken by Brampton on the half point. Now Calgary with the steal. It's Turnbull. poked away by Jamie Lee Rattray. Kikuchi on the puck. Now in behind the goal. Coming up to the neutral zone. It's Nicholson. He dumps it in. Heels off for a change. Now Laura Fortino behind her own goal to Jones. Jones dumps it across the blue line to the neutral zone. King searching for the puck. Can't find it. Now back into the Brampton zone. Howe leaves it for Simmons. Simmons finds King. King over to Richards. Richards across the Calgary blue line, dumps it in behind the goal. Still following the puck is Richards. Comes back to the point, kept in by Montgomery. And Becca King with the puck on the half boards. Taken by Richards. Montgomery now fighting for it. Right in the corner, comes to the point. Simmons there, trying to keep it in. Atlanta Lovell's there. Lilliti score for the Calgary Infernal, pokes it out and off to the bench. Shot on goal by LaRocque, and that's stopped easily by Bryant, and she covers up for a face-off. The early goal for Calgary, not what the Thunder are looking for today, not what they wanted coming in, and what is a very important game for them, with the opportunity to leapfrog these Inferno in the first place in CWHL. Andy with a shot from the point, that's blocked by Bram, goes into the corner. Calgary with it, behind the goal, Saulnier now. McKent trying to get it out, stored in her first game of the year yesterday. McKent again dumping it in behind the Brampton goal. Now Saulnier, leaves it for Jenner. Jenner cuts to the net, shot just wide. Saulnier looking for Laquette, can't find her. Going to be carried out. Eddie fighting for the puck. Stays onside, dumps it into the corner. McParland chasing behind the goal. It's Cudmore with the puck for Calgary. Now he throws it out, tipped by Jones. Jenner hangs on to possession. Now Saulnier. Saulnier looking for somebody in front. There's nobody there. Stiles puts it in behind the goal. Stiles can't get it out to Cucci there. Looking for the tip in front. Turnbull couldn't get her stick on it. Now Campbell turned over to Burchard. And she loses it. Davis dumping it back in behind the goal. Fortino finds it there. Trying to find Jones, can't. Intercepted by Davis. Davis with Turnbull. Fighting off Fortino, and they do, but Jones steals the puck. Potential 2-on-1 here, Rattray streaking. And looking for Jones in front of the goal. Can't find her. Now for the point to LaRocque. Big shot off the leg of Rattray and wide. LaRocque will dump that back in the Calgary zone. Mickelson clears it. Edney's there for Brampton. Now LaRocque. Finds Richards. Richards up to King. King across the blue line, in behind the goal now, it's Montgomery chasing the puck down. It'll come around the boards to Richards. Richards to King. Trying to find Richards again, it's turned over, but another turnover there, Montgomery picks it off. She trips up in the corner, two Inferno on her. DiCucci chased the puck away. Now it's Lobble. Coming in here, fighting behind the goal now. King and Lovell comes out to LaRocque. LaRocque finds Edney. The 2D streaking here. LaRocque will go to the bench for a change. Edney gets a shot on goal, easily handled by Brian. Back the other way now, it's the Inferno, and great stick work there by Sarah Edney to take the puck away. Back the other way comes Brampton. C does with a shot on goal, that stops. There's gonna be a penalty coming here. Seedhouse looked like she took some contact. And she is going to draw a penalty. It's going to be the first penalty of the game. Power play going to Brampton. Brampton comes into today's game with a 16.9% power play, going 1-for-3 yesterday. They sit second in the CWHL. Now the penalty kill for Calgary, not where they'd like it to be, at 81.6%. That's fourth in the league. Now Vince, feeling in front of the net. Can't find anybody. Now gets Fortino at the point. Top of the circle, she leaves it for Burchard. Now back to Fortino. Laura Fortino, the leading defensive scorer in the league. Burchard with a shot on goal, and that's right in the bread basket of Delaney Bryan. Despite being first in the CWHL standings, special teams not being a huge part of Calgary's game. They sit third in the league with a 15% power play, and as we already mentioned, fourth in the league with an 81.6% penalty kill. Richards waved out of the faceoff dot. Vince now taking the draw for Brampton. And scrambled and won by the Thunder. Burchard. Now Vince behind the goal for Richards. Looks for McParland in the far corner. Finds her, taken away there by Cudmore. And she'll fire it along the boards. It gets past Fortino and down the ice. Howe's there, leaves it now. Fortino comes back to get it. Leaves it for McParland. McParland across the blue line with speed. Looking for help. Loses the puck in the corner. And it's cleared out and down the ice once again by the Inferno. Howe behind the goal. Campbell all over her. Good pass into the corner for Burchard. She hangs onto it behind her own goal, trying to reset here. Gets something going with 55 seconds left in the power play. Turned over, but Larocque comes in to take the puck. Larocque looking for Rattray. Not there. Edney comes off the bench to take it. Close to too many men there. And that'll be tipped down into the Calgary zone, into the corner. Rattray chasing. Nicholson behind her own goal, looking to clear the puck. She does. And that'll get past the stick of Larocque and down the ice. Good kill so far for Calgary. Just 30 seconds to go here on the Brampton power play. Now Larocque to Stiles. She tips it in the zone. Running out of time here. Back to the point of Larocque. Finds Rattray. She loses it. Here to the line and now out by Cudmore. Looking for Hag in front of the goal now. Two on one shorthanded there. As the penalty is now expired, Cunningham circles into the neutral zone, allowing her team to reset here back at 5-on-5. Here to Saulnier. Jenner in the neutral zone now. Cudmore is looking for Graham on the far side of the ice. Couldn't find her. Jenner picks it up on the blue line, though. Brianne Jenner brings it in. And can't keep control of the puck. Skates out into the neutral zone with it. Saulnier dumps it in. Edney's there. Edney clearing it to King. Now Montgomery for Brampton. Richards on the far end of the ice here. Gets it back to King. Now dumped in behind the goal to Montgomery. Two shorthanded goals in last Sunday's game against the Furies for fielding Montgomery. Her second and third of the season. Calgary controls here on their own end. Clears out. Turned over to Richards. Now Whitaker. Looking back up ice is Richards, King, and Simmons there, and that's going to be called offside. King not able to get a foot back on the blue line there. Happening right now, Montreal in Toronto for their second game of this weekend series. Montreal taking the win last night, 5-1. You saw that here on CWHLLive.com. And give it away to Vint at the blue line. Vint takes a high hit from Takuchi. They get tied up in there. There's going to be a penalty here to Takuchi. She's going to go to the box for body contact. And another penalty here to Calgary as Brampton goes back to the power play for the second time tonight. 11:52 remaining here in the second period. Pardon me, in the first period. Let's take a look at another look at that penalty. Obvious call there. High hit. Looked like it got Vint in the head. Now faceoff scrambled. Nicholson comes out with it. Clears it to the line and out. Larocque comes back in offside. Calgary goal, McParland with it to Edney. Edney across to Larocque at the blue line. Looking for a tip in front, that shot deflects wide. It's Richards. Looking for help, can't find it. Nicholson clears it in behind her own goal. Around the boards to Turnbull, she can't get it out. And turn over to Vince. Vince looking for it. Poland scores! And just like that, the game is tied. A power play goal for the Brampton Thunder. Made no mistake, potting it up top corner there on Bryan, and we are tied at one. They're down in the Brampton zone behind the S, behind the net. No icing on the play. Fortino tries to clear it out, can't. That's it on goal, and right in front of the net, it's Bram with a shot. That stops. And a big slap there, deflected right in front of the goal. Cudmore unable to get an opportunity. Now it's Rattray the other way for Brampton. Rattray trying to get a shot. Can't. Laquette with the block. Rattray chases behind the goal, in front to Stiles, and she gets her stick slashed, and no opportunity there. Laquette fighting Jones in the corner, Rattray there as well. Jones trying to fight it off by herself, Stiles there in front of the net. Can't get a good shot, now Rattray alone. Good coverage there by Saulnier to find the open player and get on the puck. Stiles trying to clear it in front of the net, can't. Rattray now chases behind the goal, Stiles with it here. Candace Stiles getting pushed into the net. Delaney Bryan getting caged under there as the net falls right on top of her. That'll bring about a stop to play with 10 minutes and 14 seconds to go in the first period. We have a 1-1 tie here. Calgary scoring early. Jill Saulnier with her 10th of the season. That coming just 28 seconds into the game. And just recently it was Jenna McParland tying it up on the power play from Rebecca Vint. Over a minute ago. Richards and Cunningham on the draw here. Richards wins it, back to LaRock. LaRock dumps it in, King can't hang on to it, goes in behind the goal. Richards looking for it, can't find it. Cunningham clears it around the boards. Back to Cunningham now, behind her goal to Mickelson. Takes a weird bounce off the end boards. And Calgary will eventually clear it, but that one is gonna go all the way down the ice. Dania Simmons chasing, but that's going to be an icing call against Calgary. Brampton carrying the play right now since that goal. A couple opportunities to possibly get a lead here. They've come close, but haven't been able to beat the Lady Bryan a second time. Scramble draw, taken now by Vince. She dumps it in behind the net. Seedhouse chasing. Chikuchi on her. Esposito back behind her own goal. Now Cunningham to Mickelson and Lovell. Gets it out to the neutral zone. Whitaker's there to clear it right back in. Take it by Takuchi. Now McParland with a nice deke. Still with the puck is Jenna McParland, the goal scorer. Leaves it for Andy. Andy trying to get a shot on. That's blocked by Esposito into the corner. Cunningham clears it out and down the ice. No icing here. It goes right to Howe. And Howe forced to cover up the chasing Alana Lovell. All over the play there. No chance for Howe to play the puck. Face-off won by Stiles. Behind the goal, Fortino now. Out to Rattray. Gets it into the neutral zone. Campbell's there to intercept for Calgary. Across the line, and that's offside. Turnbull offside on the far blue line, and we'll have a face-off just outside the Brampton zone. Stiles and Davis lining up for the draw. Davis wins it back, but Rattray pushing forward, nearly able to carry the puck into the Calgary zone. Loses it, now Davis is loose. Davis with the shot attempt, that's wide of Howe. Around to Campbell. Campbell with the shot, well wide. Pieri dumps it in behind the net. Burchard's there for Brampton. Gets it around to Jones, unable to clear it. Fortino's there, gets it back to Jones, still can't get it out, kept in by Turnbull now, and finally squirts out of the Brampton zone. Turnbull through the neutral zone, chased by Rattray, eludes her, shot to the net to Jenner, and she's alone and she scores! couple interesting bounces in there, and we've got a high-flying, high-scoring game so far, just over 11 minutes into this one, and it's 2-1 Calgary. Breanne Jenner with her sixth goal of the season. We're going to take another look at that one. Turnbull circles around in the neutral zone. Finds some space. The shot on goal deflects off of a Brampton stick right to Jenner in front of the goal. So just like that, it's 2-1 Calgary. Brampton looking to bring back some of that momentum they had after their goal. Now in front to King, and she's checked in front. Saulnier now brings it out through the neutral zone. Montgomery on her, and he steals the puck. Saulnier gets it right back. In the zone now to Jenner. Round of the points. Taken now, Richards for Brampton through the neutral zone. Back in front, and LaRocque with a couple opportunities. She thinks it's in. The horn goes off. No signal from the referee. And it looks to me like Delaney Bryan managed to hang onto the puck right in front of the goal there. We're going to take another look at that. LaRocque with an opportunity. And it looks like Bryan may have got her pad on it. A lot of fans and game officials thought that was in the net, but the referee on the ice says no. It's Burchard. Around behind the goal to McParland. McParland skates out, circling around the Calgary zone, dumps it in behind the goal. It's Vint. Vint dekes out to McParland. Shot just wide off the side of the net. Now Lovell finds Hag. Hag now behind the Brampton goal. Cunningham trips up there. Burchard able to hold onto the puck. Under pressure now. Gets it out. Seedhouse and Vint battling for it against Kikuchi. She comes away with it. Now Mickelson at the point.
Stay with her.
Cuts into the half wall. Mickelson looking for Hag. Dumps it in. There's going to be a penalty here. I believe it's going to Brampton. And indeed it is. Dania Simmons going to the box. Looks like they were calling a cross check there. So Calgary gets their first power play opportunity of the game, sitting at 15% for the season, third in the CWHL. Brampton's penalty kill second in the league at 87.2%. Cleared quickly around the boards by Brampton. Kept in at the far blue line by Saulnier. Now cleared out by the Thunder. Bryan, the puck. Richards on her now, turned over to King. Trying to find Richards and can't. Saulnier to Mickelson. And Mickelson to Jenner now, back to Mickelson, playing just her second game of the season. Saulnier across the blue line, stays offside, cleared out by King now, chasing the puck with Mickelson, who manages to hang on to possession. Back through the neutral zone, Jenner can't hang on to the pass. LaRocque picks it up in her own end for Brampton and clears it right back down the ice. 1 minute, 17 seconds left here on the power play for the Inferno. Laquette circles out from behind her own goal. Now it's Lovell. Lovell with a nice move. Looking for help, can't find anybody. Fortino manages to poke it off of her stick and into the neutral zone. Now Laquette. Cleared in Cunningham now. Leaves it for Esposito. Esposito on Burchard. Held up, unable to get to the front of the goal. Galana level. Back to Esposito. Lovell again at the half wall. Looking across ice. That's poked out by Stiles. Good stick by her. And a good kill so far for the Thunder. Just 30 seconds remaining. Now Cunningham comes into the zone. Cuts towards the front of the net, shot on goal, and it's in! What almost looked like a broken play went off of something in front of the goal and slips past Howe. And just like that, it's 3-1 Calgary. We take another look, yeah, it's tough to see where that one went. Howe may have just missed it. Try that one more time. Cunningham towards the net. It may have just eluded Howe. A slow shot in front. She was expecting something a little harder. Sometimes those are the most difficult ones to stop, and it's 3-1 Calgary. Now Brampton, suddenly down by two, clears it in behind the Calgary goal. Calgary controls behind their own net. Mickelson comes out through her zone. And Mickelson still with the puck in the neutral zone, across the blue line. Campbell's there, taken down by Vint. LaRocque picks up the puck for Brampton. She gets it out to Seedhouse. Seedhouse trying to cross the blue line, held up by Takuchi. Comes out to LaRocque. In front of the net, Stiles was there. Not close enough to her, so no chance for the Thunder on that play. Back out through the neutral zone come the Inferno. Dumped in behind the Brampton goal, and they'll change. Ending now. LaRocque into the neutral zone for Stiles. Turned over there to Crom. Battle at the blue line, and Calgary unable to stay onside on the play, so we'll have a face-off just outside the Brampton zone with 4 minutes and 17 seconds left here in the first period. Score 3-1 Calgary. Lots of goals early here. In the Brampton zone, they take it out of the neutral zone. Jenner's there, took off the pass. Rattray on her, she clears it in behind the net to Pieri. She circles back. Saulnier now chasing the puck. Stiles on her. Jones intercepts the pass, and she takes a massive hit there. A collision between Saulnier and Jones went down flying. Incidental contact, no call on the play, but that could have felt nice for Jess Jones. Back into the Brampton zone come the Inferno. It's Bram trying to cut in front of the net. Looking for help, can't find it. Cudmore clears it in now. Looking for Bram in front. Fighting for it. It's Cudmore at the blue line now with Rattray who pokes it out. Jones is there. Jones into the Calgary zone. Fought off the puck by Esposito and turned over to Calgary. Nice move by Laquette to get around the defender. Ends up losing it. Cudmore turned over to Montgomery. Now King tries to poke it into the corner and does. Cunningham meets her there. Cudmore behind her own goal. Montgomery looking for the turnover, can't find it. Into the neutral zone, it's Hag. Hag now into the Brampton zone. Deets in front of the goal now. Right in the slot, the puck sitting there. And it'll be cleared out by Richards. Now Takuchi. Finds Turnbull, she loses it in the neutral zone. Bercher clears it back down the ice, and that's going to go for icing here. Ill-advised clearing attempt there by Burchard. So with 2 minutes and 31 seconds remaining here in the first period, there's going to be a face-off in the Brampton zone. Brampton can't be happy with this first period so far. This is a game they'd really like to win. They'd like to see themselves first place in the CWHL. Over the bench, into the Brampton bench. So the faceoff will come back into the Thunder zone. Play now in behind the Brampton goal. LaRocque fights the puck away. Now Vint through the neutral zone. Right onto Bryan. She feels the pressure and covers up.
Fucking call her!
Face off in the Calgary zone coming up. A minute 42 remaining in the first period. 3-1 Inferno is the score. Draw scrambled, one taken away now by McParland. She tries to get it towards the net, that goes wide. Cleared out to Bram, out of the Inferno zone now. Jenner looking for the puck, loses it. LaRocque is there and a penalty is gonna come here to Vince. She's gonna go to the box for interference, it's going to be called. So Calgary with their second power play opportunity of the game. 1-for-1. Scoring the goal that gave them the lead back. Cunningham and Richards on the draw. Taken by Calgary. Esposito and Lobel there. In behind the net, Richards intercepts, clears it out, and not quite out of the zone. Back into Cunningham. Cunningham still with the puck along the boards. In behind the net for Esposito. He's still with the puck, taken away now by Rattray as we hit the last minute of play here in the first period. That puck skips up into the Brampton bench. We're going to have a face-off back in the Brampton zone, more likely than not. Just 59 seconds left here in period number one. A minute 34 remaining on the Calgary power play. King and Cunningham on the draw. One by King. LaRocque picks up the puck and fires it right down the ice. Right on Brian. She'll leave it there for Laquette. Skates out through her own zone. Off to Lobel now. Lobel across the Brampton blue line, dumps it in for Cunningham. Cunningham looking for help. Puck skips out to Becca King and she clears it down the ice for Brampton. Now Laquette. In behind her own goal, allowing her team to change. Finds Jenner, gets it in the middle of the ice, tipped in for Saulnier. Saulnier trying to get to the net. LaRocque's there to intercept, but Jenner finds the puck. Brianne Jenner behind the goal. Trying to get it back in front, can't. Now Saulnier for the Inferno. Mickelson at the point, just 10 seconds left here. LaRocque trying to clear the puck out, can't. Campbell now trying to cut towards the net late here, looking for a scoring opportunity and can't find it. It'll squirt out to Mickelson at the point as time expires. So 3-1 the score. Calgary with the lead over Brampton after one period of play. We will be back for the second period of action here on CWHL Live.
Drive. 100% passion. 100% effort. But women in sports get only 5% of the attention. Canada's dairy farmers believe women in sports should be seen and heard loud and clear. With Fueling Women's Champions, we're shining a light on women athletes at every level. Join us. Hashtag champion her.
When I was 7, I wore these gloves. They held this stick. Well, these skates carried me over the blue line.
We won the championship. And now, it's all yours.
Cool.
Oh.
And this mouth guard.
I'll get my own. Thanks.
The fifth season is when spirit for the game gets passed down. That's why we're proud to support over 5,000 teams.
Shouldn't be a difference. Like whether you're a female playing hockey or you're a male playing hockey, it's hockey altogether. We're just part of, you know, another MLSC team that's in the mix, and that we compete for an ultimate goal that everyone wants, and that's winning the Clarkson Cup for us.
I guess I never really thought of myself as a girls hockey player. I was just like, I'm a hockey player, you know, I love to play the sport, and I'm out here doing the best I can and having fun.
Kind of a misconception is that we want to be where the men are. I think we want to be where we want to be. We want to reach the highest echelon that we can to put women's hockey on the map and make it the best place to play and show everybody that, hey, women can play.
Opportunity for young girls to grow up and don a jersey that represents the historic history of what the Toronto Maple Leafs have done.
I'm proud that this idea started in MLSE. We do take our role and position in the community very important to us, so to me this is more of an honor than a responsibility, not just for the women currently playing, but for little girls that aspire to put that sweater on one day.
The amount of, I would say, media is huge now compared to years ago. People didn't even know who we were. And I know our team as a whole, as well as individuals, can't even tell you how thankful and appreciative we are.
The person that started all this, the group organization, was MLSE. They were the ones that stepped up. Opportunity for everybody in the city of Toronto and surrounding areas to come in, see the best of the best of the women. The Toronto Maple Leafs said, you know what, we're going to make a difference. We're going to change the way the history of women's hockey is going to be.
Yeah, growing up in Canada, I think every kid's dream is to, you know, one day play in the NHL.
When you're a kid, it's the same as the guys. You dream of being in the NHL.
I would have loved to have grown up and been a hockey player and be paid for what I love to do.
It's a little tough for women to find places to play and to play at a high level.
When I tell people that I play pro hockey here, everyone says, oh, there's a women's team?
A tip shot right in, they score. Stop by Kessler, rebound, they score. Here's a break, Johnston scores.
The best hockey that's played is played right here in the Canadian Women's Hockey League. It's like watching Canada and USA in every single game. It's not just every 4 years. It's just not two teams. It's five teams.
I think women's hockey has progressed more as a sport than any other sport in the world in the last 15 years. The women are excellent athletes. They're really good hockey players. I think it's terrific hockey.
What we need to do now is get the fan to just come out and support us and follow us.
All right, ladies, we got to be focused. We got to be ready to go. Big start, big start.
You've got the top players in the world need a place to play to train for those 3 years prior to the year of the Olympics. So each team's going to have four or five or six of them. They're very serious. They're very focused. They're very talented. Instantly, you've got the best elite hockey, I think, in the world.
We have some really intense rivalries. All the girls have been playing against each other their entire lives. Yeah, there's an energy there that I think is different than NHL or WHL. For the most part, it's nearly full contact. Especially at this level, the girls are so strong and so fast that it's unavoidable. When you go into the corner battles I think are really similar.
For us, it has to do a lot with skill. There's not the big body checks or the hitting. It's still very aggressive.
If you don't get the huge open ice hits, but you still have a lot of physicality around the boards.
We have players who have retired from NCAA. They're out of the school. They're out of CIS. They want to keep playing. There's no money in it for them. So what we have on the squad is actually athletes that are just burning to play hockey.
We had 22 Olympians that attended the Olympics in Sochi. So you can imagine the level of hockey that is being played here.
Here we go. Here we go. Nice breakout team.
People who play can relate to this. It's an escape from real life. You know, with school being difficult, hockey, it's an escape from that. And that's something I'm not ready to give up yet.
In general, they're putting their careers on hold to be able to play this game that they love.
I think I'd miss it too much right now if I were to quit. I just love to play the sport that I love. And so, you know, it's worth all the sacrifice and everything that comes with it.
There is a life during hockey. We sometimes help them find jobs if they want to come to a certain city and they have never been there.
I looked for work after I moved here. hockey was, you know, number one, and I was going to make it work after that. I've been really fortunate. My company is extremely supportive. Extra vacation days if I need, and, you know, leaving early when I need to. They've even come out to a lot of my games, which has been pretty cool.
A lot of employers are kind of excited to have a player of that caliber because they're filled up with commitment and focus and discipline and work ethic and that kind of thing.
I love the fact that 95% of them are, you know, Ivy League graduates, and the fact of being brilliant in what they do. I always say to people, if you want to really see the true passion of hockey, follow one of our players.
It's hard to get a lot of games in. You have to play on the weekends because everyone has a full-time job.
I'll have to take a vacation day on a Friday. We'll leave Friday, 5 a.m. for the airport. Play Friday night, play Saturday night, play Sunday morning. Go straight to the airport after our game, get on a flight, get in at 2 in the morning or so. And then I have to be at work the next morning. So, you know, that's really tough.
You maneuver your life around your kids, you maneuver your life around your partners, you maneuver your life around your family, and all knowing perfectly well that, one, you're playing because you love to play, but two, you're playing because you're making a difference for those that are coming in the future. The role models that we are creating within this Canadian Women's Hockey League is massive in the fact that everything they represent, everything they stand for is what I would want my daughter to grow up to be, because they're following a dream and a passion. So, you know, in the past 7 years, I think we've come a long way in recognition, but you're competing with so much. I mean, you know, in the entertainment world.
I'm a true believer that the foundation that has been built with the CWHL, it is the one that will bring us that success of a professional women's hockey league and eventually get the players paid.
When I started playing, I had no other option. You know, I was playing with the boys. Or nothing really. There's been so much growth, so hopefully one day it'll get the exposure that it deserves.
You know, women's hockey is not NHL hockey. It never will be the same as the NHL game because of the physiological differences, but it doesn't mean that it can't be a great stand on its own game. It's baby steps, and it's not obviously happening as fast as everybody would like it to, but, you know, good people are involved with the league right now, and more are becoming interested.
I think this is a good product. One we can all be proud of. There is no reason that we can't grow this sport and get it to a level where women can play professionally and earn a living doing it just like men do.
When the Olympics happened, it was interesting the amount of calls I received, the unfairness of our women not being paid. And how could we have men competing for the gold medal and making, you know, $25 billion with their salaries all added up and our women making $0? In all honesty, the 13 million people who watched that final game, they made an impact with the sponsors. The simplicity for us is that in order to support our league, in order to make sure our players get paid, we need you. We need you to buy a ticket. And in $15, you will secure the future for women to be paid.
I'm Tara Watcher, and I'm a member of the Boston Blaze Women's Ice Hockey Team in the Canadian Women's Hockey League. Today we're going to pull a prank on some men's league here and act like I don't know how to play.
Awful.
for the second period of today's CWHL live action. It's the Calgary Inferno leading 3-1 over the hometown Brampton Thunder after one period of play. Calgary picking up goals from Jill Saulnier, her 10th of the season. Also, Breanne Jenner scoring her 6th, picking up her 19th points on that goal. And their third goal coming from Jenna Cunningham, an odd play in front of the net on a soft shot that beat Erica Howe for Cunningham, her 6th. Take a look at some signs around the arena. A lot of love there for Jenna McFarland and Kristen Richards. Gotta love the pictures on that middle sign of McFarland. Bet she gets a chuckle every time she goes and skates around into that corner. Teams lined up now for the opening faceoff. Remember, 35 seconds remaining on a Brampton penalty here. So they start one player short, 5-on-4 here for the next 35 seconds for Calgary. Lieber just waiting for the time clock for the intermission to run out, and we'll get right back to it here. Both teams are ready, the officials are ready. Just a moment away from puck drop here for the second period from Memorial Arena. 3-1 Calgary after one. Also in the CWHL, Montreal currently leads Toronto 2-1 in the second period. Faceoff pushed forward by Calgary. It's Campbell behind the Brampton goal. Edney's there in the corner. Off the official skate, back into Campbell. Now Jenner. Jenner with the saucer pass to Mickelson at the point. Her shot tipped wide. And around the net, Campbell with an opportunity. Howe didn't see her coming there, but the puck skirts in front of the net. Now Saulnier cuts in the middle of the ice. Across to Jenner. That's wide. Mickelson at the point. Holds it in for Bram. Bram back to Campbell as the penalty to Vint expires. That shot on goal scores! Jill Saulnier, her second of the game, and it's 4-1 Calgary. Another early period goal here for the Inferno. Scoring 28 seconds into the first period, now just 40 seconds into this period. We're going to take another look at that. Looked like just a clean shot from Saulnier that beat Howe. Yep. Straight through, and we're going to have a goaltending change here for Brampton. By the looks of it, Howe is at the bench. And indeed, Knox is coming in. Liz Knox in the game for the Thunder. Knox sitting with a 5-2 record in 7 games played, a goals against average of 2.79 and a .915 save percentage. The veteran Liz Knox in goal now, just 40 seconds into the second period. She's having a quick discussion with an official down by her goal. She may be missing her neck protector. She was motioning towards her neck, and we could hear something, and indeed it is. So Jess Jones brings it out to her. Knox will get suited up with that neck protector, and we'll get back underway here. Calgary fresh off of taking a 4-1 lead over Brampton. Looking to get back the points that they lost last night, having lost that game in overtime, 4-3 on a goal by Candace Stiles. Stiles with 2 goals in yesterday's game, sitting now with 6 on the season and 14 points. Now the officials not allowing Calgary a line change here. They've been waiting for Knox to put on her neck protector. Discussion at the Calgary bench now. So on come Pierre and Crom. And the puck is dropped. 4-1 Calgary here early in the second period. Fortino circles back in the own end. It's Burchard. Now through the neutral zone, Rattray. Back to Burchard. Cross ice to Jones. Jones dumps it in and runs right into Pierre. Both go down. No call and no harm on the play. Fighting for a down low. Now it's Esposito. Deeks across her own blue line. Now Cunningham. She takes a hit from Rattray, and Rattray's going to go to the box. Undisciplined play there from Jamie Lee Rattray. And it's going to be Calgary's third power play of the game. Just 29 seconds after taking the lead, taking a 4-1 lead, Calgary goes back to the power play, sitting at 1-2 on the afternoon. Now, while you're watching today, don't forget to join us on social media. I'm at Darren Alley on Twitter. You can follow the CWHL at the CWHL and also take a look at all the great CWHL teams and players. A lot of activity on social media from all of the teams and all of the players. Shout out to the Boston Blades Twitter account who have been, well, all over the other teams on social media with their recent hashtag trollbladies. They've been a fun follow for me, that's for sure. Faceoff won by Turnbull, now Lovell. Laquette from the point, tipped by Esposito. She takes it in her skates. Montgomery trying to clear it out, and does. Kristen Richards chasing it. Now it's back Laquette in her own zone. Into the neutral zone now to Cudmore. Across the blue line and dumps it into the corner. Turnbull chasing there with Edney. Now Lovell on the puck. She comes away with it. Looking for someone in front, can't find him. So Laquette tipped in front by Turnbull and stopped by Knox. Laquette dumps it around the goal. Cudmore cuts it off. And that'll be cleared out by Brampton. Bryan back up to Laquette. Looking for Campbell. She picks it up in the corner. Now Bram as Calgary changes. Campbell back into Jenner. Nicholson at the point. Finds Saulnier. Looking for the hat trick. That shot stopped by Knox. Into the corner now. Bram. Cross ice for Jenner. Now Mickelson at the point. Saulnier again. Back to Mickelson. Her shot wide of the net. Rebound there for Jenner. Stopped by Knox. Nice save by Knox with the blocker there. And the puck is cleared out and down into the Calgary zone. And there's going to be a penalty here to Candace Stiles, I believe, for slashing. Just an unnecessary slash on Bram as Fortino touches up the puck. So we're going to have 28 seconds of 5-on-3 hockey here. Calgary with a 2-man advantage. Candace Stiles to the box for slashing. Off to the right of Knox. Taken by Campbell. Back to Saulnier. Shot stopped by the glove of Knox. Burchard picks it up and clears it out. And down the ice. All the way to Bryan. Delaney Bryan holds it for Mickelson. Mickelson resets behind the own goal. Just 12 seconds left on the first power play. Mickelson to Jenner. Jenner can't hang on to it. Now Bram looking to come out in front for Saulnier. Now leaves it for Campbell. Cross ice to Jenner. As Rattray's back on the ice. Now Saulnier towards the goal. That's poked away by Bram and now cleared out by Richards. Bryan there nearly turns it over. Now it is turned over as Rattray. The shot into the feet of McParland. She couldn't find it. And it slides right into the glove of Delaney Bryan and she'll cover up. Now the official's having a conversation with Delaney Bryan. Looks like she was motioning to her neck as well. So another equipment issue by the looks of it here. And we're having a bit of a tough time getting a pace going here in the second period, just 3 minutes and 30 seconds in. Brampton pulling their players into the bench, taking a de facto timeout here, trying to get something going. Tyler Fiennes calls his players in from the ice, taking advantage of Delaney Bryan's equipment issue. And again, it's a neck protector problem. Looked like it was improperly strapped, possibly. And she gets it on and has put her helmet back on. We should be ready to go in just a moment. 16 minutes, 30 seconds remaining in the second period. 4-1, the Inferno lead the Thunder. As the Brampton players come back out towards the faceoff circle, Brian sets and we're ready to go once again. So a second equipment issue for a goaltender early in the second period here. 1 minute, 11 seconds remaining on a Calgary power play. Face off in their own zone here. Vint trying to push it forward, can't. Now it's Cudmore skating out of her own end, circles back, looking for help. Finds it cross ice there. And turned over. Cudmore picks it right back up. Lobble. Through to Esposito on a 2-on-0 here. Cunningham and Esposito. Back to Esposito. Scores! Not much Liz Knox could do on that one. And this one is turning into a bit of a rout. It's 5-1 Calgary as they pick up their second power play goal of the game in four opportunities. Take another look at that. Just no awareness defensively for Brampton. Cunningham gets it back over to Esposito, who pots it between the legs of Knox. Just too easy for Calgary there. Now back into the Calgary zone. Cudmore with the puck, looking for Campbell. Intercepted by Burchard. Now turn over to Turnbull. Turnbull to Campbell in front of the net. Wide open goal, but the puck skips away to Jones. Turnbull along the boards. Now Jones fighting for it. Clears it out. Fortino streaking. Can't find the puck. Now turn over to Rattray. Opportunity for Rattray. She's loose. Scores! Jamie Lee Rattray gets Brampton back on the board. It's 5-2. Seconds after Calgary made it 5-1, Brampton with a bit of an answer, turned over in the neutral zone to Rattray, and she made no mistake. Got the Jets going to the backhand, through the five hole of Delaney Bryan, and it's 5-2. Brampton getting the puck back down low in the Calgary zone here, looking to put some pressure on. Montgomery with it, trying to cut to the net. Interfered with by Jenner there. Back behind the goal, it's Richards. Richards to the point, Burchard with a shot, scores! And we have a two-goal game once again. Two quick goals for Brampton. 2:20, in fact. And their bench is going wild right now. Another look at that one. Good pass by Richards out of the corner to the point, and Burchard with the one-timer. Looked like it was tipped in front by King. And folks, this game is not over yet, not by a long shot. Brampton back in the Calgary zone, now taken away. Dumped in behind the Brampton goal, Knox there. Dumps it into the corner. See how some Nicholson fighting at the point. Comes into the Brampton zone. Now Fortino for the Thunder. She's knocked down and that puck goes offside. Seedhouse chasing and it's going to be called. And that puck is going to come outside of the zone. So despite the fact that we've had two equipment issues for goaltenders in this period. We've had a goaltender pulled. We have seen four goals and an absolute torrid pace in just 5.5 minutes of hockey. That's dumped in by LaRocque. Laquette behind her own goal. Finds Esposito, tipped and intercepted there. It's McParla now, the first goal scorer for Brampton. Her shot wide of the net. LaRocque holds it into the far point. Dumped in behind the goal. Picked up by Laquette. Esposito can't get a piece of it, but it gets out anyway. Simmons loses it. Now Lovell back the other way with Haig. A 2-on-1. Scores! Alana Lovell, and we've got another goal. Unbelievable, the action so far in this second period. Another defensive breakdown for the Thunder. And Calgary restores their three-goal lead and takes back the momentum. Take another look here. Lava with the puck on a 2-on-1 here with LaRocque back. Just hangs on to it. Finds that top corner. Nice shot there by Alana Lava, showing why she's their leading scorer this year. Now Stiles up to Rattray. Rattray towards the goal, deflected into the corner by Brian. Now Rattray fighting behind the goal, loses it to Laquette. Out into the neutral zone for Lava. And he's there to intercept the puck. Cudmore now dumps it into the Brampton zone. She'll change. Quick up to Jones. Not enough speed there. Not moving her feet. So she leaves it for Rattray. Dumped in behind the Calgary goal. And it skips out in front. Brian forced to cover Rattray and Jones right there. So good decision by Delaney Bryan to cover up that puck. I'm having a hard time keeping up with the second period on my score sheet. This is unbelievable. Just over 6 minutes of hockey, we've had five goals. Dumped in behind the goal by Fortino. Montgomery chasing there. Now King and Turnbull into the corner. Back to Fortino at the point. Her shot on goal. That goes wide, looking for the Richards tip. Behind the net now, it's Turnbull. Back to Crom. Over to Turnbull now through the neutral zone. Behind the Brampton goal, it's Campbell. Campbell unable to find it in the corner. Davis into support. Campbell again, back to Davis. Fortino picks it up for Brampton along the boards. Skips off of the glass into the center of the ice. It's Mickelson now picking it up. Megan Mickelson. Dumps it into the corner. Now Jenner. Campbell there too. Fortino comes out in front of her own goal, loses the puck. No harm done there. Cleared out by Montgomery, and that's going to go down the ice for an icing call against Brampton. So we're not even close to halfway through the period. We've had five goals scored here in the second period already. Starting to slow down a little bit here over the last minute and a half, and I say that very seriously after the amount of goals that were scored in the first 6 minutes of this period. Saulnier with Bram. Now Saulnier once again into Bram. Bram trying to stuff it in at the side of the goal there. Can't. Knox stands tall. Bram once again finds Mickelson. Mickelson into Saulnier. Back in front. Bram unable to hang on to the puck, and it's cleared out of the zone. Kikuchi battled by King, and they're going to call that offside at the line. King not happy with that call. Thought Kikuchi may have brought it in on her own. Nonetheless, it's an offside call. Faceoff outside the Calgary zone. Vincent Haig on the draw. Won by Calgary. Laquette. Cross to Cudmore. Deekson dumps it into the Brampton zone. Tipped, so no icing call. It's LaRocque. Leaves it for Edney. Has to rush to it. Gets there. Vint trying to take it out of the zone for Brampton now, and does. Rebecca Vint across the blue line. Into the Calgary zone now. Puck pops in front of the goal. Out to Edney now. Being fought off the puck. Cunningham. It's now to Laquette. Out to Haig. And LaRocque will pick it up and dump it right back in the Calgary zone and go for a change. Cutmore behind her own goal. Quick up to Cunningham. Trying to get it through the neutral zone. Can't. Jones is there. Pokes it back into the Calgary zone. Jones hard on Laquette, but Laquette with some good defensive play now loses it. Jones picks it up. Rattray looking for Stiles in front. Can't find her. Comes to Whitaker at the point. Cunningham up along the boards. Dumps it in. Whitaker chasing behind her own goal. Rattray now across to Jones. Bouncing puck. Handles it off the board. Deeps into the middle of the ice and loses it. Campbell into the neutral zone. No, not quite. Stays onside. Does Richards. Nice play to keep the puck in the zone. Behind the goal now, Richards with two Inferno on her. Jones comes in for support. She's knocked down, and that's going to be a penalty. Easy call there. Pierre is going to go to the box for body contact. And the third power play of the game coming up for the Thunder. They're one for two thus far. Once again, they sit second in the CWHL with a 16.9% power play. As you take a look at this here, they're battling down low behind the net. That call could have gone either way, but that's one. If you're the official, you're standing right there, you've got to call it. Faceoff push forward by Brampton. Now in behind the Calgary goal. It's Saulnier. Andy battling there. Richards comes away with it. Chikuchi on her quickly. Now McParland gets it back to LaRocque at the point. Back into McParland. Cross ice to Edney. Edney looking for somebody down low. Can't find him. Loses the puck. And Jenner clears it out. Saulnier shrieking. LaRocque back to hang on to the puck. Now McParland back to LaRocque. Into Vint. Vint loses it to Takuchi. She takes it around her own goal. Vint trying to get it back from her. Does. Gets the puck in front of the net. Takuchi went down there. The Calgary bench yelling for a penalty. None coming. But the puck goes right to the front of Delaney Bryan, and she covers up. Faceoff won by Calgary. Cleared out and out of the zone, down the ice. Burchard back to pick it up for the Thunder. 1 minute, 10 seconds remaining on the Calgary penalty. Burchard across the blue line. Rattray now with a shot. That stop by Bryan. Fight along the boards now. Stiles. Broken stick for Burchard. Now Rattray in the neutral zone for Brampton. Jamie Lee Rattray with a shot. That's high and over the goal. Jones back to Rattray. Rattray looking for Stiles in front. That's intercepted by Laquette. And she clears it out and down the ice. 30 seconds remaining on the Brampton power play. Knox pressured there by Bram. Fortino and Burchard supporting her managed to hang on to the puck. Now it's King. Finds Richards on the other side of the ice. Richards towards the net now. And a big save by Bryan, and King gets her own rebound and scores. A power play goal for the Thunder, and it's 6-4. The tenacity of Becca King in front of the goal on that play. As Simmons gets it towards the, pardon me, Richards gets it towards the net. One shot by King and a rebound. She tucks it around the left pad of Delaney Bryan to make it 6-4. Great work on that one. And we have goal number 6 on the period. Now puck it behind the Brampton goal. Turnbull there. Back down low to Lovell. Lovell out to Turnbull, and good stick by Montgomery to not allow her to take a shot there. Edney out looking for King. Turned over to Calgary. Mickelson now to Lovell. Lovell trying to find a player on the far side of the ice. Can't find him. Back the other way. Now comes Brampton. It's Vint. Vint trying to deke past Cudmore. Can't. Kept in by Seedhouse. Now Vint Dumped it down behind the goal. McParland there. Can't find the puck. Saulnier comes away with it for the Inferno. It's Turnbull now. Into the Brampton zone. Saulnier is there with a shot on goal stopped by Knox. Fortino tries to find Seedhouse. Can't. Laquette loses it to McParland. She gets it across now to LaRock, who will get the red line, dump it in, and peel off for a change. Bryan behind her own goal for Saulnier. Saulnier leaves it for Jenner. Through the neutral zone, she comes into the Brampton zone. Turned over to Fortino. Now turned back over. Jenner with a shot. That's wide. Bram, right on goal, deflected away by Knox. And that shot right into the glove of Knox. No traffic in front on the Crom shot. Easy save for Liz Knox. What a period we have had here. Six goals already. We have 7:05 remaining here in the second period. 6-4 the score in favor of the Inferno. Now Burchard. Looking for Rattray. Comes in offside. Brampton gets onside. Calgary behind their own goal with Stacucci. Stiles with it now. Takes the puck away from Stacucci. In down low for Rattray. Now Jones finds it. Back in front. Fortino looking to bat that puck out of midair. It's off her shin pad. In behind the net. Stacucci now. Jenner. Up for Saulnier. She gets there first. No icing on the play. Jill Saulnier. Still skating around with it, comes out of the Brampton zone. Saulnier still has it, lots of pressure there from Richard. Lucky to hang on to it. Now Esposito into the Brampton zone, shot! And that's into the breadbasket of Knox. She covers up. 6:15 remaining here in the second period. And once again, you can join us on social media. I'm at Darren Alley. You can follow the league at the CWHL. Follow the two teams at Toronto CWHL and at Calgary CWHL. Also at Boston CWHL, at Toronto CWHL, and at Lake Canadien. Edney now along the boards and out. Cudmore dumps it in. Whitaker in the corner now for Brampton. Gets it to Montgomery. Across the blue line, Pierre's there for Calgary. Now Montgomery. Looking to get it back into the Calgary zone and can't. Cunningham to Esposito. Esposito into the corner. It's Edney now behind the goal. Cunningham back to Esposito. King cross ice for Montgomery. She can't find the puck. She will change. Seedhouse on the ice nearly intercepts that pass and gets the Turnbull though. Cleared out by Whitaker. But Campbell's there. Vince strips her of the puck. Now Eddie trying to clear it out, gets a stick on it. Pierre with a shot from the point. That's wide of the goal. King clears it down the ice into the neutral zone. No icing here, it's not gonna get the red line. Davis, now for Calgary. Turnbull gets around Simmons coming off the bench. Turnbull still with the puck, that's stopped by Knox. McParland gets it up to Seedhouse. Seedhouse with a shot in on Bryan. She will hang on to the puck, covered up for a face-off. 6-4 Calgary here, 4:46 remaining in the second period. And what has been an absolutely wild period of play. Stiles can't take the face-off. It's Saulnier now for Calgary. Puck dumped down the ice. All the way to Knox. She passes it out to LaRock. LaRock now to Simmons. Simmons, bad pass to Saulnier there. That's intercepted. Now Mickelson at the point. Her fluttering shot trying to get it towards the net. It's blocked. Jenner trying to hang on to it. Rattray runs over Mickelson. Jones comes away with the puck. 4-on-3 for Brampton here. Jones cuts to the middle of the ice. That's stopped by Bryan. She'll hang on to that one. No rebound there. I think that may have been the idea what Jess Jones was looking for on that play. And it looks like Richard's going to be kicked out of the faceoff there. King on the draw now. tries to push it forward. Calgary takes possession. Songe to Brand. Back out to Songe. That pass in front of her, and that's going to go for icing. Fortino gets there first. So another face-off coming up here in the Calgary zone. Face-off one back to Fortino. Her shot blocked in front. Laquette now up for Saulnier. Looking for Bram. Finds her. Bram trying to cut past Bercher to the net. And she's going to get a penalty for hooking here. She knocked down Bercher trying to cut around her. Got her stick up into her arms. So that's going to be a hooking penalty to Bram. So another power play opportunity for Bram. So we're going to take another look at that. Bercher goes down after the hook by Bram. Easy call for the official there. Brampton goes to their fourth power play of the game. 2 for 3 so far this afternoon. Face-off won by Davis. Around the goal to Turnbull. To the point, not out. Burchard's there. Burchard gets it in, tipped into the corner by Jones. Stiles gives chase. Rattray there as well. She'll come away with it. Leaves it now for Stiles. Stiles back to Fortino. Into Rattray. Now Fortino. And Rattray trading back to Burchard across the ice. Back to Fortino. Shot on goal. Tipped in front. Now it's back to Fortino. She manages to keep the puck in the zone, only momentarily cleared out. Rattray trying to push it forward and can't. It's Davis coming the other way with Turnbull. Burchard trying to cut the pass off. The puck rolls in on Knox, and she'll cover up for a faceoff. 3:03 to go in the second period. 6-4, Calgary leads Brampton. A minute 20 left in the Calgary power penalty. Face-off won by Richards. Endy around the behind her goal to LaRocque. LaRocque leaves it for McParland, who dumps it in behind the goal of Bryan. Richards there to get the puck. Endy from the point now looking for a tip in front. Can't find it. It goes behind the goal. Cleared around the boards to Endy once again. She gets it in deep to McParland, who circles out. Now back into the corner. It's Richards. Can't find a handle on the puck. Goes to Pieri, and McParland misses that one. And it's out and down the ice with 49 seconds to go on the Brampton power play. Vint trying to leave it for LaRocque there. Almost bobbled it and gave it away, but manages to dump it in. That shot clear to the line, not out off a couple of legs there. Kept in by Edney. Cunningham now gets a handle on it and clears it out. Knocks across to LaRocque. Jenner, lots of pressure on the both of them. Now it's LaRocque. With some space, finds Fortino. She comes streaking across the blue line. Laura Fortino taken down. Still has the puck, dumps it into McIntosh. Pardon me, Montgomery. Montgomery now to Fortino. Looking down low. Back to Fortino at the point. Off of the leg of King. And that goes just wide. King looking in front of the net. Fortino alone. That's wide of the goal. And now the penalty has expired. 2-on-1, it's Bram and Jenner. That shot tipped just wide by Bram. Seedhouse along the boards, gets it out. Laquette's there for Calgary. Back into the zone. They're looking to come as Bram gets out. Clears it back out. Now Rattray, she's free with Cudmore. She scores! Jamie Lee Rattray! It is a one-goal game! Rattray with her second this afternoon. We're going to take another look as she just finds the puck. That's the second goal she scored in a similar fashion on the breakaway. That time she beats Brian just past her right pad. And it's 6-5 now. Back into the Calgary zone we go. Pieri behind her own goal. Pressure from Rattray. She gets it around the boards. It's Campbell now. Campbell back in there. Now Pieri. Stiles clears it back into the Calgary zone. Krob's there to pick it up. Now Campbell. Turnover to McParland. Now Richards back to McParland. And she's taken down. Alone in front of the net is Jones. Can't find her. The Rock at the point. Scramble for it, and the whistle goes. Shot taken by LaRock anyways, and Calgary takes exception there. Went off the shin pad of Turnbull, and there's a scrum now in the middle of the ice here. There's going to be a penalty to Calgary for sure. Not sure why the whistle went there. I think the official may have lost sight of the puck, but it didn't look like Calgary had possession at all. They got a stick on the puck there. It looked like Brom in behind the play, got her stick on the puck. LaRock didn't think so. Took the shot anyways. So just the one penalty. That's Jessica Campbell in the box. So Brampton, with 30 seconds left in the second period, goes to the power play with a chance to turn what was once a 4-goal deficit into a tie game here. 30 seconds remaining in the second period. Again, it was at 1.51 Inferno. A massive, massive comeback here in the second period from the Brampton Thunder. The officials, with the discussion at center ice, they're over by the penalty box there. Campbell yelling out from the box there, not too sure what she was asking the officials, but they're over to the benches now. Having a discussion with Calgary coach Scott Reed. Still over at the Calgary bench are the officials. Don't think the Inferno are too happy with that late shot by Jocelyn the Rock. Nothing's going to come of it regardless by the looks of it. As Brampton lines up, Calgary lines up, power play here for the Thunder. Rattray, now Fortino. Fortino with a deke. In front of the goal, she looks. Can't find a handle on the puck. Turnbull clears it out down the ice. 20 seconds left in the period. Knox now. Quickly up to Fortino. Great pass by Knox. Looking for Richards. Finds her. Richards can't keep a handle on it. Now back to Burchard. Tips in front of the net. And Brian does well to grab the puck there and cover it up. Richards lurking on the doorstep. 7.4 seconds remaining in the second period. Brampton coming awfully close to tying this game up. Face-off won by Calgary. Mickelson behind her own goal, over to Takuchi, out to Burchard. She may have a chance for a shot. Can't get a good enough handle on it towards the net, but too late. So time expires in the second period. An unbelievable offensive period from both teams. It was once 5-1 Calgary, now sits at 6-5 for the Inferno. 7 goals in the second period. We'll be back for what's going to be an exciting finish here on CWHLLive.com.
100% drive. 100% passion. 100% effort. But women in sports get only 5% of the attention. Canada's dairy farmers believe women in sports should be seen and heard loud and clear. With Fueling Women's Champions, we're shining a light on women athletes at every level. Join us. Hashtag champion her.
When I was 7, I wore these gloves. They held this stick. Well, these skates carried me over the blue line. We won the championship. And now, it's all yours. Cool. Oh, and this mouth guard.
I'll get my own. Thanks.
The fifth season is when spirit for the game gets passed down. That's why we're proud to support over 5,000 teams.
6-5 Calgary, the score after two periods of play. I'm joined by Jamie Lee Rattray. Jamie, you scored two goals in that period, two breakaways. How did that feel?
Pretty good. I mean, this is a wild one so far, and I think anything we can do to get the momentum. I think this kind of game, when so many goals, you got to want to kind of get it as much as you can, and that was a lot of fun.
So six goals so far against you guys. What are you going to do to stop that in the third period after what has been a wild game, as you mentioned?
I think just bear down. You know, I think get back to simple things. I think in a game like this, you can kind of get away from that, and I think got to go back in there and regroup and come back out for a strong third.
Now, a regulation win today, which put you guys first place in the league. What does that mean to you if you can get that done here?
I think that's pretty special. I mean, we worked hard and got a lot of big games and a lot of big wins. So I think if we can pull through, and this game is crazy, so I'm excited, and let's get it done.
Awesome. Thanks for joining us, and we'll be back for the third period on CWHL Live.
Drive. 100% passion. 100% effort. But women in sports get only 5% of the attention. Canada's dairy farmers believe women in sports should be seen and heard loud and clear. With Fueling Women's Champions, we're shining a light on women athletes at every level. Join us. Hashtag champion her.
When I was 7, I wore these gloves. They held this stick. Well, these skates carried me over the blue line. We won the championship. And now, it's all yours. Cool. Oh, and this mouth guard.
I'll get my own. Thanks.
The fifth season is when spirit for the game gets passed down. That's why we're proud to support over 5,000 teams.
Shouldn't be a difference. Like, whether you're a female playing hockey or you're a male playing hockey, it's hockey altogether. We're just part of, you know, another MLSE team that's in the mix, and that we compete for an ultimate goal that everyone wants, and that's winning the Clarkson Cup for us.
I guess I never really thought of myself as a girls hockey player. I was just like, I'm a hockey player, you know, I love to play the sport, and I'm out here doing the best I can and having fun.
Kind of a misconception is that we want to be where the men are. I think we want to be where we want to be. We want to reach the highest echelon that we can to put women's hockey on the map and make it the best place to play and show everybody that, hey, women can play.
Great opportunity for young girls to grow up and don a jersey that represents the historic history of what the Toronto Maple Leafs have done.
I'm proud that this idea started and MLSE, We do take our role and position in the community very important to us, so to me this is more of an honor than a responsibility, not just for the women currently playing, but for little girls that aspire to put that sweater on one day.
The amount of, I would say, media is huge now compared to years ago. People didn't even know who we were. And I know our team as a whole, as well as individuals, can't even tell you how thankful and appreciative we are.
The person that started all this, the group organization, was MLSE. They were the ones that stepped up. Opportunity for everybody in the city of Toronto and surrounding areas to come in, see the best of the best of the women. The Toronto Maple Leafs said, you know what, we're going to make a difference. We're going to change the way the history of women's hockey is going to be.
Growing up in Canada, I think every kid's dream is to, you know, one day play in the NHL.
When you're a kid, it's the same as the guys. You dream of being in the NHL.
I would have loved to have grown up and been a hockey player and be paid for what I love to do.
It's a little tough for women to find places to play and to play at a high level.
When I tell people that I play pro hockey here, everyone says, oh, there's a women's team?
A tip shot right in, they score! Stopped by Kessler, rebound, they score! Here's a break, Johnston scores!
The best hockey that's played is played right here in the Canadian Women's Hockey League. It's like watching Canada and USA in every single game. It's not just every 4 years. It's just not two teams. It's five teams.
I think women's hockey has progressed more as a sport than any other sport in the world in the last 15 years. The women are excellent athletes. They're really good hockey players. I think it's terrific hockey.
What we need to do now is get the fan to just come out and support us and follow us.
All right, ladies, we got to be focused. We got to be ready to go. Big start, big start.
You've got the top players in the world need a place to play, to train for those 3 years prior to the year of the Olympics. So each team's going to have four or five or six of them. They're very serious. They're very focused. They're very talented. Instantly, you've got the best elite hockey, I think, in the world.
We have some really intense rivalries. All the girls have been playing against each other their entire lives. Yeah, there's an energy there that I think is different than NHL or WHL. For the most part, it's nearly full contact. Especially at this level, the girls are so strong and so fast that it's unavoidable. When you go into the corner battles, I think, are really similar.
For us, it has to do a lot with skill. There's not the big body checks or the hitting. It's still very aggressive.
Like, you don't get the huge open ice hits, but you still have a lot of physicality around the boards.
Get the speed going, guys.
We have players who have retired from NCAA. They're out of the school. They're out of CIS. They want to keep playing. There's no money in it for them. So what we have on the squad is actually athletes that are just burning to play hockey.
We had 22 Olympians that attended the Olympics in Sochi. So you can imagine the level of hockey that is being played here.
Here we go. Nice breakout.
People who play can relate to this. It's an escape from real life. You know, with school being difficult, hockey, it's an escape from that. And that's something I'm not ready to give up yet.
In general, they're putting their careers on hold to be able to play this game that they love.
I think I'd miss it too much right now if I were to quit. I just love to play the sport that I love, and so, you know, it's worth all the sacrifice and everything that comes with it.
There is a life during hockey. We sometimes help them find jobs if they want to come to a certain city and they have never been there.
I looked for work after I moved here. Hockey was, you know, number one, and I was going to make it work after that. I've been really fortunate. My company is extremely supportive. Extra vacation days if I need, and, you know, leaving early when I need to. They've even come out to a lot of my games, which has been pretty cool.
A lot of employers are kind of excited to have a player of that caliber because they're filled up with commitment and focus and discipline and work ethic and that kind of thing.
I love the fact that 95% of them are, you know, Ivy League graduates, and the fact of being brilliant in what they do. I always say to people, if you want to really see the true passion of hockey, follow one of our players.
It's hard to get a lot of games in. You have to play on the weekends because everyone has full-time jobs.
I'll have to take a vacation day on a Friday. We'll leave Friday 5 a.m. for the airport. play Friday night, play Saturday night, play Sunday morning, go straight to the airport after our game, get on a flight, get in at 2 in the morning or so, and then I have to be at work the next morning. So, you know, that's really tough.
You maneuver your life around your kids, you maneuver your life around your partners, you maneuver your life around your family, and all knowing perfectly well that, one, you're playing because you love to play, but two, you're playing because you're making a difference for those that are coming in the future. The role models that we are creating within this Canadian Women's Hockey League is massive in the fact that everything they represent, everything they stand for is what I would want my daughter to grow up to be, because they're following a dream and a passion. So, you know, in the past 7 years, I think we've come a long way in recognition, but you're competing with so much. I mean, you know, in the entertainment world.
I'm a true believer that the foundation that has been built with the CWHL, it is the one that will bring us that success of a professional women's hockey league and eventually get the players paid.
When I started playing, I had no other option. You know, I was playing with the boys or nothing, really. There's been so much growth, so hopefully one day I'll get the exposure that it deserves.
You know, women's hockey is not NHL hockey. It never will be the same as the NHL game because of the physiological differences, but it doesn't mean that it can't be a great stand on its own game. It's baby steps, and it's not obviously happening as fast as everybody would like it to, but, you know, good people are involved with the league right now, and more are becoming interested.
I think this is a good product, one we can all be proud of. There is no reason that we can't grow this sport and get it to a level where women can play professionally and earn a living doing it just like men do.
When the Olympics happened, it was interesting the amount of calls I received, the unfairness of our women not being paid. And how could we have men competing for the gold medal and making, you know, $25 billion with their salaries all added up and our women making $0? In all honesty, the 13 million people who watched that final game, they made an impact with the sponsors. The simplicity for us is that in order to support our league, in order to make sure our players get paid, we need you. We need you to buy a ticket. And in $15, you will secure the future for women to be paid.
We're back here at Memorial Arena in Brampton, Ontario. 6-5, Calgary leads after just an insane second period here. 7 goals scored, 4 of them by the Thunder. They have turned what was once a 5-1 deficit into just a 6-5 deficit. And they will start the third period on the power play for a minute and 30 seconds. So a good chance to tie the game up early here for the Thunder. Get a little bit of housekeeping here as it pertains to the goals and assists. There have been 11 of them in this game, so chances are there's going to be a couple corrections, and we're hearing them now. Liz Knox in goal to start the third period here for the Thunder. She came in just 40 seconds into the second period after Erica Howe gave up the fourth Calgary goal. You can tell Brampton wants to win this one. The tenacity they have shown in coming back to make this just a one-goal deficit. They want to win this game. They want to be first in the CWHL after today. And here we go for the third period. Face-off won by Sarah Davis. Dumped down by Laquette early. Once again, Brampton starting the period on the power play. No icing, of course. Burchard now circles in behind her own net. Still with the puck, finds Stiles. Stiles skates with it through the neutral zone. Across the blue line, that shot deflected in behind the goal. Now Jones finds Fortino at the point. Back into Jones, pressure on her, she gets it to Rattray, though in front of the net to Stiles, that's tipped wide. Stiles behind the goal. Out to Burchard. Now Stiles once again. Burchard at the point, across the Fortino, shot! That's off the pad, good save there by Delaney Bryan. Oh, pardon me, that's Kathy Desjardins in goal now for Calgary, replacing Bryan. So a goaltending change for the Inferno. Fortino with the puck, 37 seconds to go on the power play. Rattray, shot, that goes into the skates. Rattray again! No, that just wide. A couple Brampton players thought that was in the net. Lost sight of the puck there. Burchard moving up to Rattray, quickly with Calgary changing. Now Jones in front of that stop by Desjardins. Fortino pokes it out of the neutral zone for Burchard. A lot of pressure from Jenner there, had to get the puck out. And that pass down the ice, and that'll go for icing. Now we reset in goal with Kathy Desjardins, her sixth game played now. She sits with a 4-1 record, a goals against average of 1.37, and a save percentage of 925. So good numbers and a small sample size thus far this season for Kathy Desjardins. Delaney Bryan pulled after allowing 5 goals, 4 of them in that second period. Saulnier back to the point, dumped in, and the power play has ended for the Thunder, unable to capitalize on that one. Now 2-for-5 on the night. Now with Parlin on goal, Desjardins with a nice blocker save. Puck skips in towards her, she covers it up, sliding out towards the back of the goal. Face off to the right of Desjardins, taken by McParland. She loses the puck out into the Brampton zone now. LaRocque chases it down. Now McParland. Back behind her own goal, it's Edney picking it up in the corner. Looking up ice, trying to find Vinter Seedhouse. Seedhouse picks up the puck, trying to cut in to the Calgary zone. She's taken down. Puck back up the other way. Jenner cut off by LaRocque there. Puck in behind the Brampton goal, cleared out into the neutral zone. Tucci there takes it to Calgary. Dumped into the corner. Edney and Vint down there. It's King now trying to get it back in behind her own goal. Can't. Taken now by Cunningham. She cuts in the middle of the ice. Finds Pierre on the far point. Now Pierre with it again. A shot up into the arms of Vint. She's favoring her left arm a little bit as the puck's dumped down into the Calgary zone. Now Pierre skates out with it. Esposito tips it into the zone. Now Richards takes the puck for Brampton. Lauble fights her off of it, strips her of it. Now back to the point. Shot there by Pierre goes well wide of the goal. Simmons now up to King. King with Montgomery and Richards here looking for somebody. She dumps it into the corner. Behind the net now. King around to fielding Montgomery. She battles with Pierre down low. Davis and King come in. Richards gets it on the half boards. Dumps it in behind the goal. Pierre with King all over her. Now it's Davis, Montgomery chasing as well. And Calgary comes away with it. Campbell trying to pass it up to Turnbull. Icing waved off. Good speed by Turnbull to get to the puck first. Now Davis. Richards pins her to the boards. Campbell comes in for support to take the puck. Now back into Laquette. Still with the puck is Laquette. Now Campbell. Campbell back to Cudmore. Her shot looking for a tip in front. Goes right to the Brampton stick. Now Montgomery with Rattray. Rattray manages to tip the puck forward, but it goes right to the stick of Cudmore. Cross ice now, it's up to Bram. Bram to Jenner. Jenner with a shot, stopped by Knox, and she'll hang on for the faceoff. Knox takes an extra shot there from Bailey Bram. She wasn't too happy about that. Skated out towards Bram, gave her a look, turned back into her net, and she's ready to go once again. Faceoff, scrambled, and still fighting for it. Now it's Jones who comes away with it and clears it into the neutral zone. Rattray all over Takuchi. Nearly got loose with the puck there. Already 2 goals tonight for Jamie Lee Rattray. Now it's Mickelson behind her own goal. Trying to find Takuchi. Tipped away by Vint. Jones comes the other way. Backhand shot right on Desjardins. She'll cover up for the faceoff. So an offensive zone draw here for the Thunder. Vincent Hag lining up on the draw. One cleanly by Vint. Laroque at the point looking for a tip. That shot in front of the net now. And Seedhouse couldn't get a stick on it. Lalva comes away with it up to Cunningham. Laroque stands her up. Won't allow her any space there. They're tangled up down low still. Now it's back to Crom. Crom to Pieri. Up now it's Lobel. Carries into the corner. Doesn't land a Lobel. Back to the point to Pieri. Pieri with a shot. That's tipped over the goal. Laquette. Into Hag. Hag taken down by Laroque. And Seedhouse now with the puck. She dumps it into the Calgary zone. Brampton changing. Laquette carries the puck out for the Inferno. Knox leaves the puck there, goes around to Edney. Edney finds King, she tips it into the Calgary zone. Not for long, Laquette's going to take it. Laquette out now to Campbell. Campbell leaves it, and that shot stopped there by Knox. Davis with the opportunity, and that's going to be cleared out and down the ice. Icing against the Thunder. .358 to go in the third period. Not quite the offensive period we had in the second. No goals so far here in period number three, just over 6 minutes in. After seven were scored, five of those would have already been scored in this period. Five scored within the first 6 minutes in the second period. Turnbull cuts towards the middle of the ice, scores! Beats Knox 5-hole! And Calgary gets their two-goal lead back. Let's take another look at that one. Well played by Turnbull. Just cut to the middle of the ice and put something on net. You never know what's going to happen. And she beats Knox easily 5-hole. Just as I'm talking about a lack of goal scoring, Calgary gets one on the board, and it's 7-5 Inferno. Turnbull again with it behind the net. Dumps it around behind the goal. Bertrand pick it up to Jones. She tips it out to the neutral zone. Laquette chasing. Gets it up by Stiles on the puck there. Can't get a handle on it. Now 14-0 for Brampton. Across the Bertrand. Now Jones. Dumps it into the Calgary zone. Rattray chasing. Still behind the net there. Jenner trying to come away with it. Can't. Laroque gets it back for Brampton. And there's going to be a whistle here. I believe they're going to call it a hand pass. Against Brampton. Faceoff will come just outside their zone. Brampton players unsure why the whistle went. By the way, faceoff won by Calgary. Stacucci cross ice and dumped in now. Laroque behind her own goal. Jocelyn Laroque gets it out. Now McParland carries it through the neutral zone. Her pass to Seedhouse. Seedhouse looking for Vint in front. That puck squirts by her. Now Jenner. Taken down by both Vint and Laroque. Now back the other way comes Ellie Seedhouse. Her shot, that's deflected wide of the goal by Pieri. Esposito with McParland on her. McParland takes her into the boards, but she manages to clear it out anyways. Lobel with it into the Brampton zone behind the goal. Lobel chases it down, still with the puck. Gets it out. Cunningham can't get a hold on it. Tipped away by McParland, but now back down low. It's Cunningham looking for Lobel in front. Can't find her. Hangs onto it in the corner. Come on. Cunningham leaves it for Pieri at the point. And Esposito still with the puck. Hooked by Edney. Richards will pick it up. Edney trying to support, can't get a handle on the puck. Esposito ends up with it. Edney steals it from her, dumped along the boards and off the boards and into the screen, out of play. So 11 minutes, 54 seconds remaining here in the third period. The Calgary Inferno with the Thunder, 7-5. Faceoff taken by Brampton. Whitaker clears it out in the neutral zone. Not very far, though. Campbell's there. Now Campbell with a shot. That's deflected up and into the screen. We'll have another faceoff in the Brampton zone. Don't forget to follow us on social media. I'm at Darren Alley on Twitter. You can follow the teams at Inferno CWHL and at Brampton CWHL. Of course, you can follow the league as well at ECWHL, as well as at Boston CWHL, at Toronto CWHL, and at Lake Canadian. Puck now in the Calgary zone. Jones and Rattray on it. Rattray with a shot stopped by Desjardins. Well, Brampton has already proven in this game that they're able to come back from a large deficit, down by just two here. Lots of time remaining, but you've got to think, if you're the Thunder right now, you want to try to get a goal on the board as soon as you can. 11 minutes and 30 seconds is a lot of time, but it can go quickly. Mickelson loses it behind the net. Rattray coming out in front. Jones now supporting. Trying to find a hole. Can't. Jones trying to get in the front. Also can't. Mickelson's there. Davis also. Davis into the corner now. Stiles and Jones on her. Rattray picks it up. Trying to get it back down low to loses it, but Davis is there. Stiles runs right into Davis. Both players go flying. Desjardins, that one in front of the net. Now Seedhouse with the backhander. That goes behind the goal. And General clear it out with Saulnier. Jill Saulnier. Over to Jenner. Jenner with a nice and Knox finds that one off the backboards and gloves it out of the air and hangs onto it. 10 minutes, 24 seconds left here in the third period. What a game we've had thus far. 12 goals between the two teams. Calgary with a 7-5 lead. Faceoff won by Brampton. Leading point getter, Laura Fortino for the Thunder. Fires on goal, stopped by Desjardins. Puck in behind the Calgary goal. Takuchi now. And that's tipped into the Brampton zone. Fortino's there for Burchard. Out into the neutral zone. Cudmore for Calgary. Up to Saulnier. Now Fortino. Across to Burchard. She's trying to get it up the neutral zone. Finds Richards. She gets loose here. Kristen Richards in front to Fortino. Scores! Laura Fortino! 7-6 Calgary leads now as Brampton draws closer. Let's take another look at that one. Pass in front of the goal by Richards. Finds Fortino wide open, beats Desjardins, glove side, and with 9:42 remaining in the third period, it's a one-goal game again. Unbelievable action here today. Playing the neutral zone now. Stiles knocks down Lovell. Trying to get it out now is Edney. To Rattray, dumped in behind the Calgary goal. Jones chasing in the corner. Down there low with Chieri. Egg around the goal now. Back to Chieri. And cleared into the Brampton zone by Esposito. Knocks behind her goal. Takes out Lobble there. Now it's up to Vince. Vince fires on net. Desjardins hangs on to that one for a faceoff. A number of players today looking for a hat trick. You've got Saulnier on Calgary, King and Rattray on Brampton, both with two goals. And that shot by Seedhouse goes wide of the net. McParland and Seedhouse in there. Now to Fortino, looking for another. Turnbull clears it out into the neutral zone. And that's going to be shot into the penalty box by Burchard. Out of play for a faceoff. Just to recap this third period, first goal scored by Turnbull of Calgary to make it 7-5. And the answer just a couple minutes ago from Laura Fortino made it 7-6. And a little confusion there as the puck, there's a piece of screen behind the Brampton goal that hangs out below the glass. The puck clearly hit the screen, but hit the part of the screen that was covering the glass. You can hear Tyler Fiennes yelling that puck was out, the officials not blowing the whistle. The players on the ice have stopped playing, and the puck came to a Calgary stick with an opportunity to cut to the front of the net. And looks like we're going to have a timeout called here. Or are they pulling the face-off down the other end of the ice? They're going to say it went off of a Calgary stick. Yes, that's what they're doing. They're pulling the face-off down just outside the Calgary blue line. McParlin and Seedell's trying to find it now. Fortino. Cross ice to Burchard. Comes in and fires it from way outside the blue line. That one goes just over the goal. Now Vince takes the puck away. McParlin chasing it for Brampton. Mickelson on her. Manages to control the puck out to Turnbull. Seedhouse intercepts there. Now McParland with it. Looking for Richards in front. Can't find her. She gets it off the boards. Looking for Fortino at the point. Turned over now to Campbell. Campbell coming out. Turnbull could have been free there. The pass from Campbell not going where she wanted it to go. And it goes right in onto Liz Knox, and she'll cover it up for a faceoff. 7 minutes, 50 seconds remaining here in the third period. 7-6 Inferno lead the Thunder. Kikuchi shot wide of the goal. Comes around the boards to Jones. She's tripped up by Saulnier. No call. Trying to find Jones, but it skips out into the neutral zone. There's Kikuchi. Now back in behind the Brampton goal. Endy clears it around the boards to Jones. She can't get a stick on it. Back out into the neutral zone. Kikuchi. Across to Saulnier. Now it's Larocque. Stiles unable to get the puck up ice. Graham now. Endy now. Coming out of her own zone. Loses it to Lovell. And the whistle goes. The puck looked like it may have gone out of play there. So the faceoff back outside the Calgary zone. Richards taking it against Cunningham. Richards wins it cleanly for Brampton. Fortino now. Cross ice to Burchard. She gets the zone, stops, and dumps it into the corner. Fromm with King all over her. Now into the skate of Richards. Back for Fortino. Cross ice for Burchard. Can't hang on to the puck, but gets it back anyways. Cunningham blocks that clearing attempt. Richards takes it in the neutral zone. Into the Calgary zone now. Richards into King. Puck towards the net. Now Burchard spins around. Nice move to evade the defense. Fortino shot towards the net, deflected into the corner. Now taken away by King. She loses it. Gets it back at the blue line. Manages to keep it in momentarily as it's cleared out by the Inferno. Dumped right back in by Fortino. She goes to the bench to change. Calgary off ice, now Larocque picks it off. Edney, now to Seedhouse. Mickelson behind the goal for Calgary. And Vint hit from behind there, no call. Two on her now, she still has the puck along the boards. Dumps it into the corner. McParland's gonna have to chase Esposito here. Gets to the puck. Scrambled and now cleared by Davis and into the neutral zone. Edney, across to LaRocque. She dumps it into the corner. Desjardins out behind her own goal to leave that puck there. Now Campbell. Campbell through the neutral zone, picked off by Jones. Jones trying to get the puck over to Stiles, can't, and does now. Mickelson behind the Calgary goal. Now Jones leaves it for Rattray. She loses it. Davis gets it to Campbell. Campbell battling the rock. She pokes the puck away. Now Laquette with it for Calgary. Rattray picks it away from her. Now Jones is loose with Rattray. Jones stopped by the blocker of Desjardins. No lane to get the puck over to Rattray. And that shot right into the chest of Desjardins. Burchard with a shot from the point. Good chance there for the Thunder with 4 minutes and 50 seconds left in the third period. An opportunity to tie the game. Take a look at that one as the turnover right at the blue line. Jones with the shot. Great save by Desjardins to stay position and get the blocker out for that one. Richards behind the goal with the puck. King into the corner looking for it. Montgomery now on the boards. Battling with Saulnier is Richards and King. Now comes out to Saulnier. Turned over by Jenner. Montgomery to Richards. Montgomery again with a shot. That's blocked and goes into the corner. Now Richards. Off the boards and into the corner. Montgomery there. And it's going to be cleared out here by Bram. Right back into the zone. Fortino fires it on Desjardins. Brampton's forward unit changing here. Jenner with the puck to Bram. Fortino pokes it away from her, and back they go. It's McParland and Seedhouse. And puck tipped away from them. Fortino dumps it in behind the goal. Seedhouse has her stick slashed out of her hands, and there's going to be a penalty for that. Obvious one, not one you want to take late in the game. Up by just one if you're Calgary, and it's going to be the sixth power play opportunity of the game for the Thunder. It's Erica Krom going to the box. Brampton 2-for-5 on the power play. Stiles wins the draw. Back to LaRocque. Now Rattray. Cross to Andy. Back to LaRocque. Shot! Stopped in front. Now Turnbull fires it down the ice. Knox stops it there, short of the red line. LaRocque circles behind her own goal. Waits for teammates. Stiles picks up the puck. Turnbull cuts her off and takes the puck away. Calgary with it now. It's Mickelson. Rattray right on her. Taken away by Stiles at the point. Rattray looking for Jones in front. Can't find her. Now Edney dumps it into the corner for Jones. Edney and Jones in there again. Mickelson on them. Now Jones comes out in front. Gets it back to LaRocque. Edney at the point now. Into Rattray. Rattray with a shot. Great save there by Desjardins. Jones and Rattray in front, battling for the puck, and Desjardins hangs on. 1 minute, 8 seconds to go here in the power play for Brampton. 3:02 left in the period. And we're about a minute away from Liz Knox watch to see if she heads to the bench, should Brampton be unable to tie the game sooner. Richards wins the draw. McParland, now Fortino. Dumps into the corner, McParland cuts it off. And it'll be cleared out here. Hag takes it through the neutral zone. Vince all over her. Knocks the puck away, but still cleared down the ice. Burchard now, up to Fortino. Fortino across the blue line, circles back to the point. Along the boards, down low, it's Vince. Vince across ice to Burchard, back to the point to Fortino. Fortino back to Burchard. Richard still with the puck now. Fortino with the shot. Scores! Oh, Lauren Fortino has tied the game! Unbelievable! Holy smokes, what a goal from Lauren Fortino. She has scored both Brampton goals here in the third period. This one coming on the power play. Take a look at it. Fortino and Burchard switching spots. Fortino gets the puck here on the one-timer, fires, and beats Desjardins clean glove side. It's 7-7 with 2:22 to go here in the third period. Unbelievable comeback by the Thunder. Saulnier behind the goal in front, stop by Knox. Good opportunity there for Jenner. Now Fortino up to Rattray. Rattray shot wide of the net. Fighting behind the goal, Rattray comes out with it. Rattray in front, stop by Desjardins. Goals total in the game. I am out of room on my score sheet. What a comeback by the Thunder. Down by 4 goals. They were down 5-1. And twice Calgary answered with a goal as part of this comeback. What a game this has been thus far. A minute 44 to go here in the third period. And we could see a second straight overtime game here. Jenner into the zone for Calgary. Edney on her. Edney comes away with the puck. Out for McParland through the neutral zone. Jenna McParland across the line, just onside. Back behind the net. Edney's there. Edney trying to get it in front for Vince Kent. And back the other way come the Inferno. Turnbull looking in front. That puck deflects in behind the goal. McParland there. McParland battling for it still with Turnbull, comes away with it, gets it out to Vince as we hit the last minute of play here in the third period. That puck dumped in on Desjardins. She leaves it for Mikkelsen, Rattray all over her, but she gets it out. It's Davis now for Calgary, off the boards. And that's gonna come in offside here. Davis unable to get back onside. The puck touched by Mikkelsen, and that's going to be a faceoff outside the Brampton zone. seconds remaining here in the third period. After a 4-3 Brampton overtime win, just the second overtime game in the CWT this season. Last night, we may have another one here. Not if Jamie Lee Rattray has anything to say. Trying to get to the front of the net. Still with the puck is Rattray. Still has it. Fighting off defenders. Loses it now to Laquette. Now Saulnier's loose. Burchard gets back to cut off her angle. Saulnier still with the puck. Loses it in front. Off the crossbar. Back the other way comes Rattray. 15 seconds left. Jamie Lee Rattray cross ice looking for Burchard. Can't find the puck. Now Burchard looking in front. Vince all alone. And it's stopped by Desjardins with the pad. Back and forth action late in the third period here. Both teams with fantastic scoring opportunities late. And Bailey Bram hit a crossbar over Liz Knox. That was a close one. Crossbar and straight down. Just half an inch away from most likely winning the game for Calgary. The faceoff went directly towards the net by Vince. What a third period that was. Brampton down by 2 with under 10 minutes to go. Come back and tie the game. Having been down by 4 early in the second period. And it's 7-7. So a quick intermission here, followed by a 5-minute overtime and a shootout if necessary. Let's recap the scoring in today's game. Calgary opened the scoring 28 seconds into the first period. Jill Saulnier getting the goal there. Brampton with an answer just under 9 minutes in. That was Jenna McParland with the goal. And then Calgary with 4 of their own in a row, starting with Breanne Jenner. Then it was Jenna Cunningham. Then at the beginning, 40 seconds into the second period, Jill Saulnier with her second of the game. Followed soon after by Brittany Esposito. Brampton getting back on the board after that. It was Jamie Lee Rattray on the breakaway with her first of the game, followed by Becca King. And then later in the second period, Calgary getting back on the board. Alana Lovell with her 12th of the season. Becca King getting her second of the game for Brampton. Then Rattray answering with her second of the game also for Brampton. That made it 6-5 going into the intermission. Calgary with an early goal here in the third period. That was Turnbull getting them back on the board to make it 7-5. And then two goals here in the last 10 minutes of the game. One with just under 3 minutes to go by Laura Fortino to tie the game back up at 7 and send us to overtime. Now, don't forget to follow us on social media. I'm at Darren Alley. You can communicate to me during the games. Nico should be back for our next game. That'll be January 31st. He is at Bro Behind the Mic. The league is at BCWHL. You can follow these teams at Inferno CWHL and at Brampton CWHL. Of course, the Toronto team at Toronto CWHL, that's the Furies. The Boston Blades at Boston CWHL. And Les Canadiens de Montréal at Les Canadiens. Now we're going to see if we can find an update from the earlier game between Toronto and Montreal. After Montreal took away a 5-1 win in a game that was in their control early, a game you saw here on CWHL Live last night. As we take a look for an update on the score of that one, the final score in that game, Les Canadiens 3 and the Furies 1. So Montreal has taken all 6 games from the Furies this year. Shots in that game, 33-22, the final for Les Canadiens. Natalie Spooner getting the lone goal early in the second period, the first goal of the game for the Furies. Now for Spooner, that's her 16th goal of the season. So a big season for Spooner. Matei, Deschen, and Clement Hayter with the 3 goals in response for Les Canadiens. Clement Hayter's late in the game, an empty netter. So a better game for the Furies today than what they had yesterday, but nonetheless, they don't get the result they wanted on the scoreboard. We are not quite finished here from Memorial Arena in Brampton. We are set for overtime, a 5-minute 4-on-4 overtime between the Inferno and the Thunder, followed, if necessary, by a shootout. Faceoff won by Rattray. Fortino, now Burchard. In behind the goal to Fortino. Back to Burchard. Across again to Fortino. Can't hang on to the puck. Calgary back with it. Into the Brampton zone. Burchard's there to intercept the puck. Rattray back for support. Hangs onto it. And now Fortino with it up to Burchard. Now Jones with it across the blue line. And Jones' shot. That's off a body in front. Back the other way comes Turnbull. Turnbull alone against Fortino. And Burchard's shot on Knox. She hangs onto that in her glove and covers for a faceoff. 36 seconds into the overtime period here. First shot on goal of the period there for Calgary. Andy behind her own goal now. Vince streaking down the middle. Andy finds her. Rebecca Vince just wide of the goal. And she goes crashing into the net, knocks it off its moorings, and the faceoff's going to come outside. Edney with good vision there to find Vince streaking up the ice for the breakaway. The shot just wide of Kathy Desjardins. We're going to take another look at that. All alone was Vince. Deeks to the forehand and just missed the glove side. Or we could have had a quick finish here in overtime. Vince wins the faceoff forward. Cudmore takes it for Calgary. Now Edney pushes it into the zone. Can't find Vince. Back the other way comes Saulnier. Edney takes it from her. Vince dumps it into the corner and peels off for a change. Desjardins leaves it behind her own goal. Watch wide. Now Bram out to Saulnier. Saulnier coming in for Calgary. Jenner finds the puck. Jenner now circling around the Brampton zone. Pressure from the Rock. Has it taken away from her. Bram comes out of the zone with it. Now Mickelson. Across the Brampton blue line. Looking cross ice there for Laquette. Tipped out by McFarland. Back down into the Calgary zone. Laquette chases it. Now it's Mickelson. Megan Mickelson. Up ice for Lobel. Fortino there. Leaves it for Burchard. She gets it back to Fortino. Now turned over to Campbell. She comes back in the Brampton zone. Blocker saved by Knox. Campbell comes away with it. Now turned over to Fortino. She's tripped up. No call. Out comes Rattray. Rattray with a shot. Stopped by Desjardins. Rattray and Jones in there. Now Lobel takes it away in her own zone. Comes out through the neutral zone. Alana Lobel on Knox. No outlet pass there for Knox, so she's going to have to hang on to it for a faceoff. 2 minutes and 41 seconds remaining here in the overtime period. 7-7, the score. Scramble draw, puck not even dropped there. Davis and Richards as play stopped. Looks like the clock may have kept running there. So we're going to have a short delay as they look to fix the clock. A couple extra seconds came off. Back to 2 minutes and 40 seconds remaining here. Faceoff taken by Brampton. LaRocque. Now Eddie back to LaRocque. LaRocque up ice to Richards. Looking for Vint. Can't find the puck. Now Edney trying to dump it back in, and does. Vince trying to push past Davis there. Can't. Now Turnbull clears it out with Cudmore. Three on two here. Cudmore trying to get a shot on goal. Deflects it behind the goal. LaRocque picks it up for Brampton. Circles back. Cudmore all over her. Vince has to come in for support, and she'll come away with a puck. Vint with a couple nice moves down low to hang on to it, and dumps it down the ice. Now Mickelson dumps it into the Brampton zone. Edney back behind her own goal. Trying to get it around to Stiles. Bounces off the board spot. He gets to her. Loses it in her feet and finds it again. It's Candace Stiles with the puck. Stiles up to McFarland. McFarland into the middle of Stiles. Stiles chops it over the goal. Now Jenner behind for Mickelson. Fortino there at the half boards to pick it up. It's McFarland circling behind the goal. Back to Fortino at the point. Across the Burchard with a shot. Stopped by Desjardins. Well done by Desjardins to slide across the ice and find that puck off the stick of Burchard. Rattray and Bram lining up at the faceoff dot. Won by Bram. Lobel now behind her own goal. Trips up, loses the puck. And Rattray unable to get it out in front. But Burchard to pick it up off the half boards. Turned over. And now back to Jones. Jones looks to get it down low. Bram on the puck. Cudmore behind the goal now for Calgary. We hit the last minute of the overtime. Lobel into the Brampton zone. Ilana Lobel shot. High and wide of the goal. Cudmore on net. That shot blocked and deflected by Knox into the zone. And there's going to be a penalty coming here to Calgary for interference. I think they're going to call it goalie interference on Ilana Lobel. Not what you want at this time of the game. Just 46 seconds left in overtime. You're giving Brampton an opportunity to finish this game strong. Yeah, she knocked over Knox there. Not sure about that one. Knox looked like she was reaching for the puck. Nonetheless, it's a Calgary penalty here in overtime. Timeout called by the Thunder. A little bit more of an issue with the clock here. They've got it set at 8-7 Brampton. That score is incorrect. They also had the time run. They were resetting a couple things. As they will wind that down, both teams talking strategy on the bench. As they come back out now into the Calgary zone for a face-off with 46.8 seconds remaining. And a Brampton power play. Brampton with their seventh opportunity on the power play here. They come in at 3-for-6 this afternoon. So a good night of special teams for the Thunder. Both teams actually hitting 50% on their power play thus far. 3-for-6 for Brampton, 2-for-4 for Calgary, though we're unlikely to see another Calgary power play attempt here. Burchard to Fortino. Fortino at the point. Now Burchard back to Fortino. Across the Rattray. Rattray back to Fortino. Shot blocked in front by Davis, and it comes out past Fortino into the neutral zone. Brampton has to clear the zone. Now Burchard trying to get it into Jones. She can't find the puck, and that's cleared down the ice by Laquette. Knox leaves it for Fortino. 20 seconds to go. One last shot here. Rattray through the neutral zone. Loses it at the blue line, and that's going to come in offside and cleared out by Calgary. Just 7 seconds left here. Jones behind her own goal. Out to Rattray, and time is going to expire without Brampton getting an opportunity here. So we will go to a shootout here at Memorial Arena. 7-7 through 3 periods and the 5-minute overtime. What a game we have seen here today. This game will be the second shootout of the season. The first between Boston and Toronto, that was all the way back on October 18th, won by Boston in the shootout, their lone win on the season. Final score in that one, 2-1. This game featuring 14 goals, also a tie for the highest scoring game of the year. Tied with the Saturday, December 5th game between Calgary and Toronto, won by Calgary 9-5. 14 goals total in this game, 7 aside. What a game it has been. Back and forth action, a number of comebacks by the Thunder. Coming back from what was once a 4-goal deficit. The score 5-1 early in the second period as the two captains, Jenner and LaRocque, out with the officials doing the coin flip to see who shoots first. Zamboni will come on the ice and do a quick run through the middle of the arena. And once that is done, we will get the shootout underway. One last time, don't forget to follow us on social media. I'm at Darren Alley. You can follow at the CWHL, at Inferno CWHL, and at Brampton CWHL. Check it out. Follow some of the players as well. There's some good follows out there. Communicate with us during the games as well. We will shout you out on air. Once again, Les Canadiens de Montréal beating the Toronto Furies 3-1 earlier today after a 5-1 win yesterday, sweeping away the season series, having won all 6 games against Toronto. Brampton here trying to win a second consecutive game against Calgary. They come in having played them just twice thus far this season, 2 games at the end of the season between the two as well, on Saturday, February 20th, and Sunday, February 21st. The first two games between them, both won by Calgary, 4-3 and 5-2 back on November 28th and 29th, those games taking place in Calgary. So with a win here, the Thunder would tie Calgary at 26 points for first place in the CWHL. A Calgary shootout win would leave Brampton at 25, just 1 point ahead of Lake Canadien. And Calgary would move up to 27 points, extending their lead for first place should they win the shootout here. As Zamboni does another lap around the arena, comes back down the center of the rink, giving the players fresh ice in the middle, not allowing the goalies to pile up any snow in front of their nets. There's been a lot of action down low in this game. Again, 14 goals combined between the two teams. Once again, to reset the action, 4 goals scored in the first period, 7 goals scored in the second period, and then 3 goals scored in the third period with 2 late ones from Laura Fortino to tie this game up. And the Zamboni is finished, and we're just about ready for the shootout here. Bench discussing shooters here. Can't quite get a glimpse of who it is. I think I see both Rattray and Jones on the list. Again, our broadcast booth directly above the Brampton bench. And we are ready to go here. It's going to be Jess Jones taking the first shootout attempt of the year for the Brampton Thunder. Jones waiting at the blue line, ready to go. Kathy Desjardins relieving Delaney Bryan to begin the third period, waiting in her goal. Whistle goes, and here comes Jones. Deeks across the blue line. Forehand shot stopped with the blocker of Desjardins. Brampton 0-1 on the shootout attempt. If you take a look at that, nice blocker save, good positioning by Kathy Desjardins in goal. And Brittany Esposito on her way down the ice here for Calgary's first opportunity. And her shot, Deeks, and can't find the puck. Good move by her, had Knox on the far side of the goal, just couldn't get her stick on the puck, too much on the backhand Deke. Now Jamie Lee Rattray for the Thunders. We take a look at that one. Esposito, little too much on the backhand there and couldn't get it back on her forehand. Now Rattray for Brampton. Rattray down the ice, scores! Jamie Lee Rattray goes backhand, forehand, beats Desjardins, sliding to the other end of the net, and Brampton takes a 1-0 lead in the shootout. Jamie Lee Rattray now coming the other way. It's Bridget Laquette. Fakes the slap shot, deeps, and it's stopped by Knox. She faked the slap shot, looking to get Knox out of position, but she followed all the way and made the save. Laura Fortino could put the game away here with a goal. Fortino down the ice. Deeks, and great pad save by Desjardins, sliding across the ice. take a look at that one. Great sliding pad save by Desjardins. Sarah Davis needs a goal here. Davis down the ice, stops, shoots, missed the net! And Brampton takes it in the shootout! What a comeback! What a game! Take another look at that one. Davis, first shootout attempt, stays out wide, looking for an angle, can't find anything on Fort Knox, and she stands tall in goal. The shot deflects wide of the net, and Brampton wins this one. They were down 5-1 in the second period, a 4-goal deficit, and they come back to win in a shootout. Now, before we get to the Tim Hortons three stars, while the teams shake hands at center ice, the CWHL and CWHL would like to thank Canada's Dairy Farmers Fueling Women's Champions Program for their valuable support in presenting CWHL streaming in 2015-16. We'd also like to thank league sponsor Scotiabank, Sportsnet, Winsport, Bauer, Tim Hortons, Toyota, Molson Coors, the Globe and Mail, Bridgeforce, Porter, Gong Show, OMGs, the Calgary Flames, the Toronto Maple Leafs, and the Montreal Canadiens for their invaluable support of the Canadian Women's Hockey League. And the Tim Hortons three stars. As they often do, the Thunder bringing in a local junior team. Is that the Stars? And Bridget Laquette, the third star of the game for the Flames. Pardon me, for the Inferno. Kristen Richards, a deserving second star here today. She was all over the ice. And Jamie Lee Rattray, 2 goals for the Thunder. A big part of their comeback today. 8-7 in the shootout is the final for the Thunder. As Brampton salutes the crowd, a crowd that was treated to quite the game today. So we thank you for watching today's game. The final, once again, 8-7, Brampton in a shootout. So on behalf of our technical crew led by Steve Mitchell, I'm Darren Alley. Join us next time on CWHLLive.com and have a great Sunday.